Our interest in our life here is our vocation in the church as Trappist monks. Cistercian is our official name in the order. The reason the church values our life so much is we live the contemplative monastic life, living as Saint Benedict intended in his rule, a life of prayer, community prayer, personal prayer and contemplation, and work, not just any work, but work that supports ourselves. So we pray, we work, and we live in community. For those called to this way of life, that's a full program. This monastery was chosen at this spot by a brother from the monastery in Rhode Island who came looking around in Virginia and settled on here, and he could not have picked a more fortunate space. The kind of work that we do to support ourselves is the keeping of the monastery, taking turns cooking. They even risk having me cook one or two days a week, take my turn, and taking care of our own household. But also to support ourselves, we have rented fields for those who are operating the cattle farm and the vegetable farm. When I first entered as a youngster, we operated the cattle farm ourselves, but that had to change by 1980 when our numbers had decreased. What we concentrate on now is the bakery. Since the monks came here in the early 50s, they were obviously baking bread for themselves, a home-style bread. We started selling it commercially. We got squeezed out of that, and we saw the handwriting on the wall, so we had to discontinue the bread in 1990. We changed to something that was a bit more manageable for us with our smaller numbers, holiday fruitcakes with a little brandy poured on top before we sealed it, which certainly makes people happy. It turned out to be so hugely popular that we had to learn how to operate in computers and the internet and all that, mail order, and a whole new world was introduced into our doors, which we weren't all that excited about, but we rose to the occasion. Another product that we produce in our bakery is creamed honeys, and for those who turn up their nose at fruitcake as being not very environmentally friendly, they're very happy about the honeys. One dimension of our life that in recent years, these past 10 years, has emerged is the growing awareness of the environmental crisis in the world. And we've taken very seriously that part of our life, which is living in God's nature, being stewards of God's creation. So people coming here find a great sense of beauty and peace and restoration for themselves. And to preserve this, we have embarked these past 10 years on a serious ecological improvement, putting all the land in conservation easement. We introduced a public cemetery on our property for natural burial, not to have artificial chemicals or anything, but simply buried as people were always buried in the past until the last 100 years or so. The simplicity of natural burial is very attractive to many people today. In today's world, especially during this year of consecrated life, the focus in the church is on the renewal of vocations for people to seriously consider religious life as a way of committing themselves in service of the church. We come to the monastery not to be known, but to serve, and serve by our prayer for the church, our prayer for those who come to us seeking God. If they feel God may be calling them, there is a great great blessing in that. Myself, after being in the monastery 54 years, I can testify that it is something that God does not stint his grace.